Welcome to the Android Phone Security and Privacy course. In this course, we'll show you how to set up a PIN on an Android smartphone to protect your personal information and data. There are many types of Android phones. If your Android phone is a different model to the one shown in this demonstration, the steps might be slightly different, but you can still follow along. Adding a personal identification number, or PIN, is one of the easiest ways to secure your phone and the information on it. It's a bit like a key, so if someone doesn't know your PIN, they won't be able to unlock your phone. If you already have a PIN set up on your Android phone, keep watching to learn about other security options, including how to change your PIN and add fingerprint security. Let's look at how to set up a PIN to lock and unlock your phone. Starting from the home screen, swipe up from the bottom of the screen to view all the apps. Look for the Settings app, which looks like a cogwheel. Tap on it to open the Settings app. Scroll down until you find Lock Screen at the bottom of the list and tap it. If you already have a PIN on your phone, the next few steps are similar to those for changing it, so it's a good idea to follow along. Look for Screen Lock Type at the very top of the screen and beneath it the word Swipe. The Swipe option doesn't protect your phone, so tap on it to open the Screen Lock Type options, where we can change this setting to a more secure option. For this demonstration, we're going to set up a PIN which has medium to high security and is quicker to enter than a password. Tap PIN. Now you need to enter at least 4 numbers for your PIN. Entering more numbers will make the PIN harder to guess, so we're going to use 6 numbers in this demonstration. Choose a 6-digit PIN that's easy for you to remember but hard for others to guess. To create a strong PIN, use random numbers and avoid number patterns. Keep a record of your PIN in a safe place. Now, use the number pad to enter your PIN. It can be inconvenient to have to tap OK each time you enter your PIN to unlock the phone, so tap the circle if you want to avoid this. Tap Continue. Enter your PIN again to confirm it. Then tap OK. Some notifications options might appear to let you change how notifications appear on your lock screen. If you're happy with these settings, tap Done. A pop-up might also appear to ask if you want to back up your PIN. If you already have an account set up with your phone's maker, you can select Agree. But for this demonstration, we'll tap Cancel to return to the lock screen settings. If you're worried someone may know your PIN, it's easy to change it. Just tap on Screen Lock Type and repeat the steps to set up your new PIN. It's time to practice using your PIN to unlock your phone. Swipe up from the bottom of the screen to return to the home screen. Press the power button. Don't hold it down for too long. Just press it once quickly so the screen goes dark. Now press the power button once more to wake the phone up. The lock screen appears, showing a padlock at the top. Swipe anywhere on the screen and a number pad will appear for you to enter your PIN. Carefully type in each number of your PIN. If you enter the PIN incorrectly, you'll have to try again. If you enter the wrong PIN too many times in a row, everything on your phone might be erased. Keep a record of your PIN so you don't forget it, and make a backup of your phone. If you can't remember your PIN, you can always restore your phone's contents and settings from the backup. We'll show you how to backup your phone in another course. Once you've entered the PIN correctly, your phone is unlocked and ready to use. Now, let's look at how you can use your fingerprint instead of a PIN to unlock your phone. It's called fingerprint security and it's easy to set up. Fingerprint security can be a faster and more convenient way to unlock your phone, but you will still need a PIN to keep your information secure. Your PIN can always unlock your phone, even if fingerprint security is set up. To set up fingerprint security, first return to the Settings app by swiping up from the bottom of the screen and tapping the Settings icon. Find the Lock Screen option again and tap it. Then tap on Screen Lock Type once more to view these options. At the bottom of this list, you'll see some other ways you can unlock your phone. Your phone might allow you to unlock it using your face or fingerprint. For this demonstration, let's tap on Fingerprints to set this up. Read through the tips about how to register your fingerprint and tap Continue. Now, locate the phone's sensor and place your finger on it. Depending on your model of Android phone, the sensor will be either in the Home button or next to the camera on the back of the phone. Follow the instructions on screen to scan your fingerprint in a range of different positions. Continue to follow the instructions until the phone says your fingerprint has been added. Next, you will be asked if you want to add another fingerprint. If you don't want to, tap Done to return to the lock screen settings. Swipe up from the bottom of the screen to return to the home screen. To test that fingerprint security is set up correctly, press the power button to lock your phone. The screen will go dark. Now, press the power button again to show the lock screen with a padlock at the top. You can swipe up to go to another screen and enter your PIN, or simply hold your finger against the sensor to unlock your phone. It's as easy as that. You've reached the end of the course and should now know how to protect the personal data and information on your phone using a PIN and your fingerprint. If you're unsure about any steps, you can rewind the video or click the chapter headings to jump to the start of a chapter. If you're ready to move on, there are many other courses to explore on Be Connected.